Using StudentVUE can be a helpful way for you to check your grades and attendance, view your report card information, and submit work if your teacher is using the online assignment features. You can access StudentVUE from your district laptop by clicking on the Students tab at the top of the district website. Another way you can quickly access StudentVUE is by clicking on the yellow folder titled TPS Favorites on the top left menu of the Edge browser. From the StudentVUE account access page, click Login with Microsoft and log in using your district username and password. Once you have logged in, it will look something like this. Note the navigation menus are located on the left side of the screen. Synergy Mail. In Synergy Mail, students can read and send emails just as in any other email server. You will see a red notification indicating any unread messages in your inbox, and you can reply to messages here. Using the calendar. The calendar screen displays all assignments for all of your classes. Filter the calendar to view assignments by class in the first dropdown. Notice all the classes are checked. You can filter by assignment type, formative or summative categories, and the third dropdown, you can choose to filter due, missing, or scoreless assignments. There are no events to show on this day, but you can use the arrows to move through the calendar day by day. On the right side, you can switch your view to month so you can see more events. My favorite is to view the whole week. That way, when you have multiple assignments due on the same day, you can see them all in a list. Clicking today gets you back to the current date. If you want to see only certain events, you can uncheck boxes to hide certain event types from your calendar view. Finally, you can also click on any of the assignments from your calendar view, and it will take you to the details for that assignment. We will look at more specifics about assignments when we explore the Gradebook tab on the navigation menu. Attendance. The attendance screen displays your attendance information. Here you can hover over the day of the week to view the attendance code marked for that day. In the grid below, secondary students will see their attendance totals by course and by period. You can hover over each bar graph to view the attendance details. If you scroll to the bottom and toggle Detail on, you can view your attendance by day and class period displayed in a table. Schedule. The class schedule page displays your class schedule information. From here, you can view the course title, room number, and send an email directly to your teacher by clicking on the teacher's name. Class websites. Here on the class website screen, you will be able to view any content a teacher has added to their class website. You can also navigate between classes using the drop-down at the top of the screen. Note that you can click between topics to view different information that your teacher has posted on the website. Teachers can use this place for announcements and to post resources, such as the course syllabus or other learning materials. Course history. Under course history, you will see your graduation status, including your credits earned and any credits remaining. If you hover over the progress bar for a subject, you can view specific information about the credits earned for that subject. Turn the details view on so that you can see more about the credits earned, credits in progress, and credits remaining in a grid below. Scrolling down, you can view any required tests for graduation. Gradebook. Now let's take a look at Gradebook. This is where you can view all gradebook information that teachers share. Secondary students will see their sections, while elementary students will see subjects. You can view your grade for each course here. If you have any missing assignments, the total for that class will show here. Also, there is a graph of your overall class performance on the right. Each dot represents an assignment, and you can hover over them to see the date and score. You can email your teacher by clicking on their name. Clicking on a course title will bring us to a screen where you can view the details and assignments for that class. It's important to double check that you are viewing the grading period and course that you want to see. Clicking in this box allows you to select a different class. At the top of the page, you will see a snapshot of your class with your teacher's name, your grade, number of missing assignments, and upcoming assignments. Your assignments and course content shows on this page with the beginning of the year on the top and the latest content on the bottom. You can filter several ways to find what you're looking for. If you know the assignment name, you can type it here. If you have been marking assignments as done after you turn them in, you can use these filters. On the right, you click to jump to the assignments for a certain week. Let's take a closer look at the entries on this page. Each entry will have a date and a title. Entries that are marked course content are not graded. These are learning materials that your teacher is providing for you, such as PowerPoints, videos, articles, or websites. Assignments will be marked as either formative or summative. If your teacher has graded your work, you will see a score between 0 to 4. If your work has been marked as missing, it will indicate this too. Notice the calculator on the right side. Clicking the calculator icon will open a window to allow you to see how a change in the grade for that assignment would impact your class grade. Now let's scroll down to the bottom to take a look at what's coming up. If you click on the entry title, it will open up for more details. Here you will see if it is formative or summative. You can view the assignment or content instructions. If your teacher shared a rubric with you ahead of time, you can view it by clicking on the rubric tab. If your teacher is asking you to submit work online, the submission tab will be present. Click that and follow the instructions to upload and turn in your work. If you'd like, you can click the Mark as Done button to hide the assignment from your list. Note that there are two other ways to filter your information here at the top right corner of the screen. We just looked at Course Content View. On the Assignment View, students can view their overall grade as well as their performance by assignment category. This student will see his overall grade is a B+. He also has two missing assignments. In the Assignments grid down below, students will see an overview of all assignments in the gradebook. Just like with the other view, you can click on the assignment title to see a more detailed view of that specific assignment. For this assignment, I can see the notes that are provided by my teacher, giving me feedback, and scrolling down, I can see how I scored on the rubric. Back at the top of the screen, you can see a third view. Clicking on Standards View will itemize your performance by standard if that teacher is scoring standards on assignments. You can view your overall grade on the standard. If you click the name of a standard, any assignments that have that standard associated with it will show up with the scores for the standard on that assignment. Report Card. The Report Card screen is helpful to view the final posted course grades from the last marking period.